Hello, and I'm Yao. I'm from Asus Motherboard team. I'm in charge of the ROG Motherboard series. I work as a product manager in ROG Motherboard team. This time, I'm really glad to release our refreshed model of the Apex. And this time, we called it ROG Maximus Z790 Apex Encore. And this time, we've the most important feature is to improve the memory overclocking this time, and we do a lot of effort to release three more brand new features for better memory overclocking performance. Because this motherboard is designed for extreme overclocking, safe boot is a really useful button. If you face like a boost failure, you can directly press the safe boot button and you will directly put the motherboard into the BIOS safe mode. And you can directly adjust the overclocking setting under BIOS without any clear CMOS or anything else. Our CPU performance is always calculated by the multiply with the base clock. The base clock is the BCLK. And while you enter in the operating system, you can directly press BCLK button plus or BCLK button minus button to directly manipulate the BCLK. And really simple for overclockers to adjust their base clock without re-entering the BIOS and just plus one of the base clock and reboot to the operating system. It saves a lot of time with these two BCLK buttons. As we know, if you want to measure the true voltage of a V-Core or a VCC GT or VCC AUX, it's really difficult to find a specific way on the motherboard to measure the true voltage. But we bring all measurement points together as a probability point, and you can just easily use the multimeters and measure the true voltage every time while you are doing the overclocking. It's really easy to find the measurement point here. While you are doing the extreme overclocking, you can just press the retry button and the whole system will maintain your overclocking settings and just retry it without resetting it. As we know, a lot of the benchmark application, we have to pass the several kind of the tests. When we pass from the first testing to the second testing, we need more time to adjust your overclocking setting for make sure your system can successfully pass the testing. So you need to press or turn on the pause switch and the whole system will pause at the moment and give you more time to adjust your overclocking settings. And there are RSVD switches and N2 mode jumpers here. And both of them are for extremely overclocking scenarios. Because if you turn on the RSVD switch and or you jump into the N2 mode, it will enhance the power input of the CPUs and make the CPU can successfully boot under the really extremely low temperatures, like by overclocking by N2. AI overclocking feature is our most popular features on high-end gaming series motherboards from Asus. And if you turn on the AI overclocking, the system will automatically profiles your CPU and profiles your coolers and predict to the optimal configurations and make your system put into its limit and give you the best performance while just a single click you turn on the overclocking button. Of course, because this board is designed for extreme overclocking, so we have put a special setting and design at the back of this motherboard. And as you can see, under the extremely low temperature during the extreme overclocking scenario, it will cause a condensation at the back of the PCB. And especially at this three part, like a CPU socket and a memory socket, and of course the PCI socket. So the special circuit can automatically detect the condensation situation, and it will flash in the LED here and just warning you, you have to solve this issue and prevent the risk of the short circuiting. This motherboard also designed for the extreme memory overclocking, and we are so glad to introduce our latest new generation of the AEMP2 Asus Enhanced Memory Profile. And as you can see, the DIMM.2 start next to the standard DIMM modules. Thus, the DIMM.2 start is for our add-on card. It's our DIMM.2 card, and it can support additional two M.2 slot on this small add-on card, and just give you a choice to install more and more M.2 devices on this motherboard as you want. So this time, Z790 Apex Encore can support up to 5 M.2 slot on board with this DIMM.2 add-on card. The next part is our DIMM flex function. Because we set a special design on our DIMM module, it can solve the stability issues regarding to the temperature readings. For example, if the operating temperature go over 55 Celsius degrees, the system will automatically decrease the performance at the background and make sure your system always stays stable. This is one of our most important features on Apex Encore. It's called ROG Memory Fan Kit. It's not only designed for the ROG aesthetic, but also it provides a really good cooling performance for the DDR5 memory modules. Because as we know, the heat dissipation issue is always be the critical problem for the DDR5 overclocking. One of more important things that we have designed the thermistor of the memory module this time, and this thermistor will be the fan source of this extra floor fan, especially for this ROG memory fan kit here, and you can adjust the fan rotation ratio. And this time we bring our PCIe Gen 5 SSDs directly on board, as you can see at the first slot, just under the CPU socket. And this time we are really glad to introduce our latest Wi-Fi solution, is Wi-Fi 7 BE200 from Intel. And BE200 brings up to 320 MHz bandwidth. Our mission is to provide extreme overclockers to reach the best record more easily than using another motherboard. For the overclockers, these features are really useful and really user-friendly for them.